What's going on, guys? It's time for another episode of the Aussie Noobs Guide to Bossing. Today we're going to be covering the Barrows Brothers. There are six Barrows Brothers consisting of Aram the Blighted, Darrup the Wretched, Guffin the Infested, Carol the Tainted, Torag the Corrupted, and Varrup the Defiled. Aram is a mage base and Carol is range based, while the other remaining four are melee based. The brothers are all buried in tombs in a graveyard which is in Mauritania. The graveyard is east of Morton and south of Darkmire. You fight all six, with a random brother being located in the tunnels below the tombs. This changes with each attempt. At the end, you have a percentage potential at your chance of receiving a Barrows piece of equipment, which on average is about 1 in 17. To fight the brothers, you must dig on each mound to enter the tomb and then interact with their tomb, which summons their ghost. It is worth having the hard Mauritania diaries completed, as you'll get double the runes, and it's worth it. For our gear setup, we have the Helm of Nettersnot, the Occult Necklace, the Imbued Zamorak Cape, Broad Bolts, Book of Darkness, Bando's Chestplate, Ivan's Staff, Barrows Gloves, Eternal Boots, a Seer's Ring Imbued, and Bando's Tassets. Over to our inventory, we've got a Bando's Dehyde Body, Saradomin Chaps, Ancient Dehyde Boots, the Book of Lore, Dragon Crossbow, Ava's Assembler, the Archer's Ring Imbued, the Amulet of Fury, two Monkfish, an Abyssal Whip, Dragon Defender, Fire Cape, Berserker Ring Imbued, Dragon Boots, Prayer Potion, couple of fire runes, and a rune pouch consisting of dust runes, lore runes, and death runes. I would suggest, if you're using the Ivan staff, that it is upgraded so it can hold 2,500 charges. As for how to get there, I'm lucky. I've got a Barrows teleport portal in my house. Otherwise, you can use Barrows teleport tabs. This is basically it. It's just a bunch of mounds inside a brick or stone fence. As we can see on the map here, this is where it is. Also, make sure you've got auto cast set to Ivan's Blast, just so you don't go in there and start whacking in with the stick. Now, if you have the diaries done, you could use your Mauritania legs to get teleport to Bergdorot. Or you could do the Shades of Morton minigame teleport, but that'll be every half an hour. Or you can use the fairy ring code and then run through. Otherwise, the next fairy ring code is going to be pretty much near Caniferous, which is a pretty long walk, and then it just becomes a chore. You could also use a Morton teleport scroll. You don't want to be using the Slayer ring up at the Slayer Tower, it's just too far. Now, one crucial piece of equipment is a spade. If you don't have one, you can't do it. Luckily for idiots like me, there's one that spawns in this little shack, so you can just grab it if you forget one. I always start off with D'Arrick first. Make sure you have your Protect from Melee on your Quick Prayer. Dig on the top of the mound and then search the Sacrifagi or whatever it's called, and then he'll appear. What you want to do is just attack him with your mage, and it's pretty simple. There's no mechanics really, you just want to attack it. Next, I'll make my way over to Varrack. Varrack is pretty much the same as Darrup, except he can hit through your prayer sometimes. But there's no gear switches, just protect from melee, attack him, and then get ready to jump out as soon as you can. every 18 or so seconds, your prayer does get drained. I think it's about 12 points that it takes off. So you want to get in there, attack it, kill it, and get out of there as quick as you can. Whenever you see that ghostly big head pop up, that's basically when your prayer's getting drained. I was unlucky here, I just got my prayer drained. Now we make our way over to Aram, we're going to whack on our range gear because he attacks with magic. Obviously range gear has high magic defense, so this will negate as much as we can. Dig in the crypt, search it and put in our protect from magic and attack. I use my special attack in here because there's basically, with my gear set up, there's nowhere else I can use it that it comes in handy. Now we make our way south to Carol. Carol is a range attack, but we pretty much have the same gear set up as the first two, and protect from range. You can use your melee gear in here if you want to, but I find mages pretty much gets it quicker. The melee gear I only just use for the creatures in the tunnel at the end. Once we've taken out Kirill, we're going to go to the northeast over to Guffins. We've got 8 prayer left, but the last 2, you can, with this gear, you can kind of tank them, so it's not necessary. While you're in the tunnels looking for the last brother, your prayer's still draining as well, and it can take a little while to get there. So there's no point in recharging your prayer because it's just going to drain before you get there. Which is why I have a prayer pot in my inventory. If you get Diara and you know you've got him down to a couple of hit points, he can smack you pretty good. So always have a prayer pot to recharge your prayer points when you're in the last fight, just so you're safe. Depending on which brother is the last one, a full prayer pot could last me anywhere from 4 runs to about 15. It just depends. Now we're at Torag, the last brother. Because we've been able to fight all the rest, we know this one's going to be a tunnel. We're going to enter. And now this is a bit of a maze as to get to the chest. As you can see, there's always going to be one lighter colored door than the rest. This is the one that you can open. It changes every single run. Sometimes it'll be close to the center, sometimes it won't. You've just got to make your way through. Turn off your auto retaliate so you don't waste any of your spells, and follow the doors through. At any point, the brother could appear when you open the door, like here. What you can do is, because each corner is a tunnel that you could pop up in, there is actually an invisible ladder there. So if you get one of the melee brothers, all you have to do is stand behind this invisible ladder and he can't even attack you, which is a pretty handy thing to know. This doesn't happen very often, and most of the time you'll get all the way to the chest where you have to open the chest for the brother to appear. But sometimes you do get lucky. Once we've killed him, we can see in the top left corner all the brothers have a green tick, and we've got a potential percentage of 66.5. What you have to do now is just kill some of the other creatures in the tunnels. You want to get your percentage to about 88%. That's ideal because you'll get the most amount of runes without getting any bolt racks, which if you're doing it for money, that's pretty much the optimal percentage where you can still get a good chance at a drop and still get a lot of runes to make money. This one's basically been a whole loop, so it would be the longest one. Sometimes you can get a bit closer. walk into the middle here. At the last door, you have a question to answer. If you've got rune light, it's already highlighted. You just click on it. It's just a pattern thing that you've got to figure out. So now I'm in the final room. I'm going to kill a couple of these creatures to get my potential up to 88%, or as close as you can. Sometimes you'll be a little bit under, sometimes you'll be a little bit over. As you can see, this fella got all the way to the center before having to open the chest to summon the brother. Now we're at 82.8%, we'll kill this last one, which brings us up to bang on 88%, so this is perfect. We'll open it up and see if we get any items. Chaos runes, death runes, and cash. It's actually not too bad, it's a handy drop. No items this time, but that's the fun of it. Now we're going to cast teleport to house back home, instead of running all the way out again. Use our rejuvenation pool to top up all our stats, and then head back through the Barrows portal. With this setup and my levels, I can pretty much just go constantly over and over again. It's very rarely that I do need to bank, which is pretty handy. Back when I first started, that wasn't the case. Barrows is pretty much one of the easiest bosses to grind for not bad loot. I'd say it's an entry level boss. It's not as easy as Obor or Byro Fighter, the Hill Giant and Moss Giant bosses, but as for members, it's probably the entry level member bossing. So that's it guys, here's another quick full run, sped up without me blabbering on. Good luck, and I hope this helps.